Hello out there in Model Land. Bet you weren't expecting to see this already. Round 2 models through AMT. The Superboss Funny Car Chevelle 427 fully blown drag car. It's a 65. It's fully blown. I hate when they're half blown. When they only put half a screw in the blower, you don't get any pressure, you can't go anywhere. It sucks. So thankfully, this one is fully blown. Retro packaging on this for their 75th anniversary. Looks awesome on there. Of course, on the back, gives you all the parts listing and everything. They put so much work into the boxes, I figured I can start showing them off a little bit more than I do on the show. So enjoy that cool retro art, that awesome 60s style writing on there. It's a lot of fun. So let's start taking a look at the parts with the all new tooling. We're going to bring out a full set of tires. This car can only be built as the funny car or altered wheelbase vehicle. It cannot be built as a stock 65 Chevelle. It's absolutely impossible with the parts in the kit. So we've got our front skinnies. Very, very light tread on there. No names on the sidewalls. They are a semi-hollow vinyl, nice and flexible, and they look every bit the part. They're quite sharp looking. And I gotta say, the best pad printed tires in the business. I say this a lot for round 2 models when I build them, but truly, they are gorgeous. These sand down so beautifully. We'll see it in the video. Racemaster Dragster tires, all pad printed, black wall on the other side, soft hollow vinyl. They are a very nice looking tire, and really, those white letter tires really bring out the build. We've got a transparent red tree, and that's just for our taillights, which means I don't have to pre-tint them. We've got clear parts tree, and I like how they attach the glass. These large tabs on the back and on the front, so we can get that in there. Use my Mod Podge to glue those in place. They are crystal clear. Modern Engineering, you can read my name right across there. By the way, if you're wondering where I get these padded work tables with the script in it, I just ordered them from Amazon. They got a bazillion on there. We've got our grill here with our headlight blackouts in it. Not blackouts, but they're actually like metal covers, so we can black wash all inside there. Got our rear bumper. Got our blower parts here. Oh my, I'm so happy that the blower is mostly molded in one piece. We just have to attach our front and back. I hate it when it's halves and all that. Got our blower butterflies. Oil pan in chrome. Intake in chrome. But that's not the only chrome tree. We've got a nice one over here with some beautiful wheels that are molded completely open. Our shifter, our moon tank, our blower lid. Got the front and back to our blower on there. Got our valve covers. And our front axle is done in chrome on that tree. We've got some paper goods in the box. I'll show you this because this hasn't been in a box yet that I've opened up. AutoWorldStore.com is where you can buy direct from Round 2 models on their website. I always link in the description, but they've got some really awesome stuff. HO scale. I wish they would send one of these to the show, or all of them. Send all of them. I'll do a review on all of these if they send them these 1/6 scale Schwinn bicycles. They're so cool looking. They've got 1/64 die cast, or what you'd call like a matchbox scale. They've got the big 18th scale. I've reviewed some of those, so if they want to send some more of those to the show, look at that Cadillac. That's gorgeous. Almost all the, I haven't built this one, but every other kit in that advertisement for model kits you can find on the show. And of course, they still make slot car sets and slot cars and everything. Fast and the Furious, Motorsport. They got all kinds of stuff on there. All looking awesome. We've got a sweet decal sheet. Now, this one made me laugh because I know that there are people who will watch some of these videos. A lot of times I'll miss something on a decal sheet. Check it out. They made sure to point it out. They probably did this for me. Probably not, but you know, I like to think I'm important. Gauges, two sets, and it should say, Chris, pay attention. So there's two sets of complete gauges in that modern white style. Got racer names all the way across the bottom. Chevy powered, Wheelie Wesley. We got Hall and Humphrey, Hyperactive, Chevelicious, Time Machine in two different scripts on there. Goldman Engineering. Really nice looking decal sheet for your drag race style models. Let's go to the other side of the table. That's all for multimedia. Running loose in the bag was the drag racer seat with belts molded in. So be careful that doesn't go flying. We've got our plain Jane interior tub. No door panel moldings or anything. Cut out and an actual location for the seat, which I appreciate. On this one, we've got our hood with the cutout for the blower. We've got our very simple dashboard with just the spaces for the gauges on there. Top of our differential, obviously the seat was hanging out right there. We can see that these molds, since they're all new, they've been retooled. They are in mint condition. We've got our chassis here. Cylinder heads. Engine and transmission. Racing steering wheel. The chassis looks lovely. Love the one-piece tubbed out look. We've got our leaf springs, parachute, blower drive, distributor, wheelbacks, roll cage. It's a beefy roll cage on this thing. So since it's new tooling, we'll go a little bit slower on those parts trees than I normally fly through them. We've got the other parts of our roll cage. We've got two-part headers, but they've got these large rectangle tabs. So they should go together quite easily, slide in together, glue together without too much of a fight. We'll see how that goes in the assembly process. And then finally, we've got our track bars, drive shaft, roll cage parts, steering, and then, our altered wheelbase slash funny car style Chevelle body. Beautifully done. The door panels are deep enough that they should accept a marker well. Got our trim along the bottom. Trunk molding. Very, very crisp. I haven't seen any flash on any of this, and I don't expect it. When they say all new tooling, I expect it to be in all new tooling shape. Nice trunk there. All the way around. It's even got trim on the alter wheelbase, so it'll be a little bit of a fancy funny car. A little bit of a fancy one. So that's all the parts. It's not a massive amount of parts. Should be a fun build. I'm going to start gluing mine together right now, and I'll come back with that.
We'll be right back.
Being all new tooling, I expected, in fact, I demand that it go together easily, and this kit definitely does. very little to worry about on this thing when you're going to be putting it together. There's not a lot of parts to begin with. It is a funny car or altered wheelbase car, so it is should go together quite well without fighting anything. Our differential glues together, and the glue pretty much gets rid of the seams for you, so you don't have to worry much about that. You saw me cut the chrome front axle off. Now, a lot of times I will automatically put these together because I want to paint over them, and a lot of this stuff doesn't go together easy. But then again, as you saw during the assembly process, this just drops into some holes on the front spring, so it will assemble quite nicely, and then it has little holes to attach the steering right there. So we can actually get this together and have a true chrome front axle without having to repaint it or do anything like that. So I was pleasantly surprised. Now, you saw me glue the interior to the chassis, and that was so that I could get these parts of the frame, the reinforcements in there. And then we did glue the roll bar together inside the body, inside the interior. So that's all in place the way it should be. We can get that painted, and then we can take our tape off of the frame. Our interior will come away free. We can paint that in a metallic tone or whatever you want to do with yours. And then we have these in the exact same correct position. We don't have to worry about anything. They line up perfect every time on the interior where they should go. And that's why I did that. Then we've got our springs in place on the front end, which you could, you know, paint those and attach those later. The attachment points for the springs are quite large and steady. So I'll be painting the differential and the rear springs separately and then attaching it later. The front springs I did attach, and we can just take our front axle and those holes in the springs, check that out. It just fits right in. Some super glue when we're done painting, and that will be a perfect fit because the fit right now is good, but not absolutely perfect. Once we have a layer of primer and paint on there, it's going to be phenomenal. And then we can have our cool front axle on there. So that's a rarity with these kits, that it fits so well and it's not fiddly, that I can actually just do it that way. And we've got our 427. I'm not a fan of the chrome for the intake there, so I glued it on. There's a nice stud. You could always do your ignition later and glue it in place. I just glued it in now. We got our starter on there. These nice large holes, if I can get a hold of it, on the cylinder heads will fit our exhaust system. We'll have to wedge them in there, but we'll get them in there. Take a little bit of careful planning, line each one up. There we go. Now they're starting to go in, but we'll get them on there more carefully and they will fit tight. Our headers glue together without fail and they all line up nicely. End up with two parts like that. Those go together well, so I mean it's all coming together nice. Check out the blower. Normally with the multi-piece blowers, you get glue on everything. Well, this one didn't. This one went together perfectly. Maybe I won't need to paint this, though I do like to paint them a more metallic finish instead of chrome. So we'll decide at the end. Same with the moon tank. Glues together beautifully. And our blower. The blower I'll leave chrome. The insides I'll end up doing with a Tamiya clear red when we detail the car. And folks, that is it for pre-assembly. Our links here, our drive shaft, our steering link, our wheelie bars, those are all going to get dealt with later once we get some paint on them. We've got our parachute, our belt system, and our wheel backs. We got our beautiful wheels here. Water pump with its little fuel nib there. Valve covers, I'll leave chrome. Shifter, I'll leave chrome. On this tree here, we got our shocks, I'll leave chrome, oil pan, and our breathers. So yeah, and then we've got our body. That's ready to go. When we're all done, the chassis is just going to slip right up inside there. Somewhat like so. The interior will be on there. We'll get it up in there. Don't think I'm going to have any problems. So I've already went washed the body and the hood in simple green, scrubbed them, let them dry. I'm going to get all these parts over to the paint booth, start getting some color. Well, there isn't much left to my build of the 65 Chevelle with the big honking 427, or pretty much whatever you want to call that big block. They give you the numbers here separately and then cubic inches. So if you want to use those decals, like on the box art, they say 475 cubic inch. I mean, you could do a 502, you could do a 513. You can pretty much say whatever it is with that big blower on there and everything, and it would be, you know, correct for your build. We got all these cool decals to go on. I'm digging the box art when I saw it, and that's what I'm getting myself close to. So that's what I'm just gonna do with my own little twists to it. To take a look at everything, we've got our interior done, which I just did in like a bent metallic that's been tack welded together. Very simple gauge cluster, extremely simple dashboard with a metallic face and a black top. They only painted the black top for anti-reflective reasons. Got our driver's seat, steering wheel, and T-shifter there. So that's all set. Glued in the roll cage, the roll bar, and the interior is done. I left the bottom black, but you do want to make sure you paint it because you can see it from the bottom. So they just sprayed it a quick black underneath. On the chassis itself, be careful. I recommend putting the engine in the chassis. The transmission goes to a little pin in this transmission support. So once you press that in, that's a really nice tight friction fit. Once it all has paint on it, it will hold the engine in place in the right place, then put the headers in. You will probably be bumping into your shock absorbers. See those chrome little shocks next to the headers right there? So you may have to relocate your shocks. You may want to put your shocks on last after you get the engine and the headers in place. You can see how the headers should come through, and they pretty much touch and go right through the frame. And these headers are friction fit with those large pins that were on them. And I love that white ceram coat look with the primer over the black. We've got our blower all set up. I don't have the scoop on until we're all done, but I do have the breathers on the valve covers installed now. There's no glue to the engine to the motor mounts. That friction fit right there is holding everything in place, and then the drive shaft fits in nice and tight as well. You saw the wheel and tire package go on tight. I washed them with a flat gray Tamiya to give them that real dragster wheel look, and then sanded the tires down. Everything else super glued into place. That axle went in perfectly. Like I said, the wheel and tire package are just friction fit. Glued in the links to the rear end, and that's it for that chassis. And it looks really nice, and it fits really nice, and I'm really excited about that. You can see the blower scoop here with our little red butterflies. That will be glued on last. No idea where to put the moon tank because it's not mentioned in the model whatsoever. Maybe I'll just glue it in the back here. There's nowhere in the front to put it. I mean, I guess you could try to put it there, but it's going to interfere with the belt and stuff if that was the real world. So who knows where. Parachute obviously will go on the rear of the body. We got the body all done. This is just friction fit pressed in. Got the grill done, the hood with its hood pins. We got our trim painted. Our glass is in, the rear bumper's a friction fit, and so are the taillights, though on the other side of the taillights I did drop a little bit of super glue to keep them from being lost. That silver across there was for when I masked it off. That's it, folks. Super easy build. When I get done with this, I'm going to put on my preferred decals. I'm going to give the body a couple coats of future floor polish or quick shine, whatever you want to use. You've seen me apply it. And then I will simply place the body over the chassis. You can see the interior. That's where our frame's gonna fit. So we just set it down over that, and right down it goes. You've also got those triangles on the bottom. Those fit inside your rails. And you're done. That's how easy this is gonna go together at the end. I don't anticipate any problems, but if I do have any, I will let you know. Otherwise, I'll see you in a minute. Boy, Round 2 Model sure is putting money into their car model catalog. Truck models, car models, sci-fi models. They're really coming all out. 2023 is seeing a lot of new kits. This one, a redo of the 1965 Chevelle funny car. This thing is tough. It's a 427 fully blown, remember? We were having a little fun with the side there. 427 fully blown drag car. So it is a cool model kit. They redid all the tooling, all new tooling for this kit, and it fits together like it should. There was no fuss, no muss. The body just falls on the chassis. The rear bumper presses in. The front bumper presses in with the grill. The engine fits. As you can see, it lines up nicely around the hood scoop. Nothing screwed up there. The chassis is a beautiful piece of work. The engine drops in. The headers fit super nice. We got these gorgeous pad printed tires. I did a gray wash inside the wheels to give them that drag racer lightweight wheel look on there, and I think it looks wonderful. The decals will let you build any size engine you want. I went with the 427 since it says it on the box. The box art itself says like 475 or something, but otherwise I went with my version of the box art. I copied most of it from the STP to the Performance Automotive and the Time Machine and the driver, but then I put the Moon Racing Cams logo on the hood. I thought that yellow camshaft on either side in the hood grooves looks really nice against the blue, and I threw on the AMT decals at the bottom of the rear quarters. I wanted those on there. I think that checkered flag just adds a sweet look to it. Otherwise, I built the box art because I saw the box art. I thought it looked really cool. In person, the blue is much darker. On camera, it appears lighter because of the lighting, but it's closer to the blue they used on the box art, but not quite as dark. I wanted a little bit of a lighter one to go with the yellow on the moon and on the 427 logos, and the blue pretty much matches the Time Machine in the shade that they used. You can see they come across in the light almost as the exact same blue. So I enjoyed this kit. It was easy to mask up like the box art. You saw how easy it was. Just ran some washi tape on the sides and across the back. We had that done in no time. Easy to detail the engine. Pretty much everything about this kit is easy. It's a low parts count, great detail, but doesn't get overly done and drive you absolutely nuts with it. Two coats of future floor polish, put on about 15 minutes apart from each other, and left to dry out in the 78 degree sun today in Wisconsin, and she looks lovely. It's got the blackouts for the headlights, the metal covers. The cover art shows actual glass headlights, I think, because they're not protruding out. So I think that's what they did on the cover art, but the grill in the kit is the ones with the headlights removed and just the metal cones in their place, so they don't have all that glass out there. So looks great with a black wash. Didn't have to get in there and detail anything and just let it go as it is. I thoroughly enjoyed the kit. I will link down in the description. This should be coming out within the next couple months, I think. I got the box. I get the production copies so you guys can see them right away. This video will be airing mid-week, and it shouldn't be too long before you can start getting those pre-orders in at the links I will provide. As always, thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over for a full build. I loved every second of it. Super easy kit. The decals laid down perfectly. No cracking, no splintering. They've been doing a great job on their decals lately. Thank you all the viewers out there, the guys who have joined up for the membership. You'll be getting entered automatically into the contest to win kits as I give them away in the future. And for those that haven't, check that out. Otherwise, you don't have to. You don't have to join the memberships whatsoever. We're going to be producing content for everyone, and we will see all of you at the next review.